Take a look at the world today, we are more technologically dependent than at any time in human history. This is what drives our society, this is what drives our world. If we are going to continue as a nation to be competitive in that environment, if we're going to be able to have the things that we need to drive the economy, to improve the quality of lives, we have to have some of the best STEM education in the world, producing the best STEM workforce in the world.
We have a tremendous need for technology-related folks going forward. So not only are we wrestling with the issue of the baby boomers going into retirement, but also with the fact that we're not graduating the same number of engineers that we once were. The population seems to be less interested in the science, technology, engineering, mathematics field.
Science, technology, engineering, and math are very important to Chevron. We recognize that the interest in those fundamental subject matter for students of all ages, from kindergarten through secondary education, is vital to create the pool of professionals that will help Chevron and the industry and the nation as a whole continue to lead and to be competitive into the 21st century and beyond.
The classroom in many ways is limited in terms of their resources and what they can physically do in a school. What the Science Center tries to do is to support them with programming and experiences that they can't really do in a classroom. So we can create exhibits, we can provide programs, we can build demonstrations that would be very unlikely for a teacher to be able to do in a classroom by themselves. And so we work very closely and very much hand in hand with the schools to look at their goals and their objectives and then determine how best can the Science Center support teachers and classroom educators to do what they are trying to accomplish.
There's a lot of discussion in formal education about proficiency in science, but there's not as much discussion about excitement. How do kids get excited about science and want to do science? And if they get excited, that will carry over into the classroom.
What we do at all of the STEM programs at the Science Center is that we create tremendous excitement and age-appropriate activities. You can see kids doing biotechnology and robotics and advanced materials experiments, but all at their appropriate age range, and also introducing them to professionals in the field. There's nothing like talking to someone who's actually doing it and getting their energy and their enthusiasm. And I can tell you that we witness this firsthand all the time.
We know a big part of what the STEM Center is going to do has to happen outside of the classroom. And that means that we're going to provide special opportunities that go beyond what you see in the regular curriculum, that let you go beyond what teachers can do and that they have the resources to do in the classroom, to do things that are more hands-on, that involve professionals, and that could really be the spark that makes a difference in a kid's life, that shows them that STEM can be exciting, that it's something that they could do, and something that they could have a career in right here in this region.
Every day we use science and technology, engineering and math to produce energy for the nation. And the Carnegie Center makes those topics real.
One of the things that we pride ourselves on as Eaton is supporting the community. And Carnegie Science Center has proven itself to be a very good partner in reaching out to the children of the community and the community at large.
Our program was Bubble Science, and we started with bubbles because it's something that's very relatable, that all kids have sort of blown bubbles before. They know how it works. They know the basic mechanics. And then, so from there, we started to ask some questions. And we started to ask things like, well, how are you going to blow a bubble? Are you going to blow a small bubble or a big bubble? And that starts them thinking, you know, what do I need to change if I want to make my bubble small or if I want to make my bubble big?
The reason why I like to go to SciTech Days is because it gives more of my students an opportunity to experience science, engineering, and technology, which have become a passion of mine, to share with my students. It is a good opportunity for them to see real engineers, to see real industrial people working with science, and they get to experience it, not just here in the classroom. I know how important it is, science and engineering, for our future. And I try to foster a love for it, and Future City is a good avenue for that.
The vision for the project is to give them a very hands-on engineering contest. Okay, a lot of times in the classroom, they don't really get a full idea of an engineering project. And this is my favorite contest, absolutely. Through the chain reaction competition, they can have everything.
We want to make sure that everyone has access to STEM programming, that everyone realizes the opportunities. I mean, for example, if you take a look at women, they make up just under 50% of the workforce in this country. And yet, if you look at STEM careers, they're less than 20%. We think we can make a difference there. We can show girls and women that they too can have a role in STEM and that they can have careers that will provide a good economic base for their family and also give them a fun and exciting career.
We're looking for something where the girls can be learning, but not really know that they're learning. So they got to use a lot of their creativity, and they were learning along the way.
One of the key benefits of our programming is providing students a sense of self-efficacy, a sense that they can do science, so that when they go into the classroom, they feel confident that they can succeed.
Informal science is all about learning, but it's also about igniting a passion for learning and for science and technology, and allowing that to lead you into your future.